Welcome to the Impulse tutorial series. These videos will go over how to use the core features of Impulse, and more videos will go over new features as they get added. Impulse is an acoustic simulation suite designed for creating impulse responses to use in convolution reverbs. Instead of doing what most convolution reverbs do, such as mixing prerecorded IRs together and having a library of recordings of different real spaces for you to select through, Impulse allows you to virtually design these spaces by placing sources and listeners in a 3D scene. This scene, as it is referred to in Impulse, allows for materials to be set, which determine how Impulse's internal sound propagation algorithms treat the various surfaces of the space as they interact with them. So, you can essentially design any kind of reverb you want. This is just a basic getting started guide. Other videos will cover more specific topics. If you are just getting started out in Impulse, there is already a built-in tutorial which you can start up at any point by going into the Help menu. The info bar at the bottom will also give context to every element of the interface that gets moused over. For now though, we can just go through everything together. Start by opening up a demo project. Demo projects are Impulse projects which have already had scenes imported, materials set, and source and listeners already positioned. With these, you can go through the most basic workflow of Impulse without having to do much. The complexity level just describes how complex an Impulse demo might be, based on how many different materials there are, as well as how many sources and listeners are available. Let's try out the classroom demo. Now that the project is loaded, we see that objects are showing up on the sidebar. Each object in the scene will show up here, and its position, rotation, and other values can be adjusted either through here or through using the 3D positioning overlay that shows up when you click on an object. To move the camera around, Impulse offers a Blender-like control scheme where you can shift plus click your middle mouse button and drag the camera around. Just hold down the middle mouse button and drag it to orbit the camera, and use the mouse wheel to zoom. Additionally, if you are on a laptop and don't have a middle mouse button, you can hold down the Alt key instead. Let's look in the third menu on the sidebar. This is the simulation menu. In order to actually create a usable reverb IR, Impulse first needs to actually simulate the acoustics of the space based on the source. We already have a source object created through the demo project, so all we need to do is press Simulate. Once simulation runs, it will be pretty much instant in this case as there isn't much geometry to trace. We can go through the next menu, the Rendered Settings menu. The Render Settings menu contains all of the settings for actually rendering the impulse response based on the acoustic simulation data. Another video will go over all of these settings, but one thing we will do is change the spatial mode from mono to binaural. Now that that has been changed, what we need to do is press Render at the bottom. This triggers a rendering process which will use the selected listener as the basis for creating the IR. This process runs in the background and the time it takes to process varies on the render settings. Once that is done, we can go into the next view and actually look at the impulse response that was rendered. On the sidebar, we have options to preview the audio as well as some statistics about the rendered IR. And below, we have various kinds of analysis that were performed on the audio. The analysis section includes a waveform of the audio, as well as a frequency analysis via a spectrogram. The third panel here is referred to as the spectrum panel, and can provide maximum frequency values of the audio file over time, as well as the averages. Additionally, there is the mode view, which is used to approximate how the given listener position resonates in the low frequencies against the space. Finally, there is the spatial energy panel, which displays a readout of signal volume based on direction. This is, of course, only available in modes where the audio is non-mono, and its resolution changes based on the spatial quality. If we want to save the audio, that can be done here. In this case, we have chosen to normalize the audio file so it will better fit a convolution reverb that will be used outside of Impulse. Now that we are in Ableton Live, we can hear how our IR sounds when applied to different sound sources. The first blue audio clips are the dry versions, and the second red audio clips are the wet versions. When listening, notice how the IRs can resonate against the space identically as modeled in the impulse engine, as well as how realistic the late reverb diffusion sound. Additionally, the sound sources have been converted to mono, but notice that the wet reverb sounds slightly to the left. This is because the direct source to listener in impulse was not centered to begin with. Thank you for watching. More Impulse video tutorials will be available soon. There is also a full guide for Impulse available on our website.